New daily highs for infections, record hospitalizations, daily death, rising deaths will soon follow. Lasting symptoms. Virus roars back.
Cases are still spiking. 214,000 lives lost. New numbers not seen since the summer. 50,000 cases reported for the past 4 days. Record number of hospitalizations.
But now they have a source of fear that is the most pervasive and all-encompassing power that they've ever had, which is the fear of pandemics. Governments love pandemics the same way that they love wars, because it gives them power, it gives them control, and it gives them the capacity to impose obedience on human beings.
Let us fight for a new world, a decent world, that will give men a chance to work, that will give youth a future and old age a security. By the promise of these things, brutes have risen to power. But they lie. They do not fulfill that promise. They never will. Dictators free themselves, but they enslave the people.
We had a leader, Franklin Roosevelt, and he said, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself. He understood that fear would drive us into totalitarianism.
You, the people, have the power to make this life free and beautiful, to make this life a wonderful adventure. Then in the name of democracy, let us use that power. Let us all unite.
People like Bill Gates and Anthony Fauci and Davos and all of these people who are running now the global economy, they have understood for years that they have a power that no totalitarian government has ever had available to it.
To those who can hear me, I say, do not despair. The misery that is now upon us is but the passing of greed, the bitterness of men who fear the way of human progress. The hate of men will pass and dictators die, and the power they took from the people will return to the people.